Good morning. Welcome to my Just For Me morning. And I'm having my Just For Me morning in my Joy of Art journal. I'm working on a relaxing practice of leaves. I went to my tablet and found Getty pictures of eucalyptus, and I sketched out some using my GraphGear 1000 mechanical pencil and an eraser. And this is my sketch. And when I looked at the pictures carefully on Getty, I realized that the smaller, more tender, newer leaves in, or the inside leaves in a cluster are the lighter ones, and everything towards the back gets darker. So I thought, my, that will be an enjoyable challenge. I'm going to be using my Schmincke watercolors, and I have wet down, my group of greens. I'm going to be probably primarily using 533, and I've picked these two new brushes, my silver black velvet numbers 4 and 8. I want to give them a try. I have my water right at hand, my Viva towel, and I'm going to start here in the middle with a very, very small amount of this green. I have to be sure that that center, those tiny, tender little center flowers are very, very light. Almost silvery green. And over here. And now I'm going to go back to these upper leaves at the end of the grouping. They seem to be have a different shape from the central eucalyptus, and I'm going to lay down some of that same color just to take away that whiteness. And I'll be building color on top of them. But this color I'm very happy with, because it does suggest a silvery shade of green. And now this next grouping. I want to be a bit darker. Having a double challenge here because this is not watercolor paper per se, so I'm having to work with the challenges of the paper. And the only way that I can keep this looking lighter than this shade is to make sure that there is darker up against it. And of course, it's going to dry much lighter. I'm liking the amount of water that this brush holds, and I'm certainly liking that wonderful point. just a little bit too spotty right there, so I'll just use some clear water, or semi-clear water, to let that give that a place to move to. This is going to look rather different than if it were on watercolor paper, because I'm doing wet on dry. So I'm having to accept, and this is going to become an art word, blotchiness, on this first coat. But I have to say that I'm enjoying that. Now I'm going to darken up a bit. With these leaves that are in the back. This leaf is under those two. So I'm going to let it be a little bit lighter. I need to get rid of this line. I'm not happy with it, so let's see about getting rid of that puppy right now. This one. I find this so relaxing. I'm hearing the clock tick on the wall and the small sounds from the computer, and I'm just enjoying what is surrounding me, and I think that is the whole point of this experience. Sorry about that. I was so into listening that I wasn't looking. I have a big monitor up in front of me, so I should be able to see what you're seeing. I'll try to do better. This to look a little bit mottled, right? Now I'm not happy with that puppy, so I'm going to have to work on it. This one next. This. Trying to have a bit of variety of greens because leaves, certainly. Are not all the same color under any circumstances. Same shade of green does not prevail. Thankfully, not in nature. Redo this one also. Because I like that color. I want to bring it up here a little bit. This one. now the stems, I want to put a bit of color on them. I think I'm just going to add the slightest touch of brown. With my green. Now, I'm going to let these air dry because I have some errands to do and I will have something to look forward to. I will have something to look forward to when I come home. But there is some variety of coloration, but it must be better. I must add to it. I must do more with it. Yes. I'll be back. Well, I'm back from my errands, and I have myself a Starbucks chai treat, and so I want to work now on finishing up this first layer. Of color. And then I have gotten out a few other colors from other plastic palettes. Hoping that if I move this slowly enough, it will not be too off-putting for you, but I have to do that in order to achieve my painting goals here. this black velvet number 4 round is certainly on my keeper's list. Spend some time remembering where these leaves overlap each other. And now, I'm going to give that a place to go. So that if that water decides to run, that paint decides to run into this water, it can do so. And maybe just a little bit more of that color down here. Here. And here. thirsty brush. Let's see if we can't get some of that out. Yes. Now some varieties of color here and there. There it is. New brushes, even the best of them will sometimes let you know that they're upset when they're first used. Let me move up a little bit. Put some palette mixture greens here. A bit of that fresher green up here also. Now a little bit of help, I hope, for this one. Yes, that's a little bit better. This one out of here. It's a little bit too strong. And one more that needs a little TLC. Go. bit more yellow. Let's have a little bit of this, but also try this. Put a little of this strong color in here. Just up here a little bit. Now let's see where we stand here on variety of color. Maybe a little freshening up in this one might not hurt. Quite incredible the way all of a sudden the painter, in this case moi, is more willing to take chances and let things happen . And indeed, things do happen. And sometimes for the good. So, I think I'll just add some of the green to one side of those stems so that we perceive them as green rather than brown. I picked some Daniel Smith Cascade because it granulates, and I had forgotten that I wanted to give it a try. And since this is my playtime, I'm going to give it a bit of a try. Yes, I am. I'll try this one. I'm not too happy with this. With this one. So. Yes, 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 that darkness. Always have to have contrast of light and dark in order to make things look important that we want to be important. I'm not trying to make the pigment do anything more than it wants to do, so. Now, of course, I could keep at this and keep at this, but I'm going to start playing with the background colors that I thought I might give a try. I want to just add a touch to the parts that are drier. So, I think I'm going to use my Daniel Smith Moon Glow. Very lightly add just a bit of background coloration. Just to cut some of that harsh white. I don't think you're seeing as much of this as I'm actually putting on. So I think I'll add a little color gonna rub it out a bit, blend it out. If it runs into some of the damp places on the in the leaves, that's fine. If it liberates some of the green from the leaves, that's fine also. Yes, this is granulating a bit, as you can see right here. And I'm going to keep going. And I will be back when I have added my moon glow all around the edge. I'm going to use a little palette color on the stencil just to slightly add just a touch more color. Not too much. Just to know that Kilroy was there. And I'm going to end with a very fine, very light touch of brown or gray. Maybe brown here and there. Let's start in here. Just to pick out these focal eucalyptus leaves, just the tiniest bit. I think I'll follow the line of the stems. Just a little bit. Darken this bit under this light just a little bit so it'll show off a little bit. Alrighty, now I don't want to overdo because this is my playtime. So, I do hope that you have enjoyed sharing my playtime and just for me in this journal, Joy of Art, because it certainly has been a joy. Version of a rather expressive eucalyptus, and I certainly have learned a lot about shading and layer upon layer of watercolor, wash upon wash, and then just a little tiny, tiny, tiny bit of stencil, watercolor through a stencil. Not so bad. I do hope you will be back to join me again when I have some playtime. And if you have enjoyed this, please give me a thumbs up, leave a comment, share with a friend, and I would certainly appreciate it if you would subscribe to my channel. Bye now.